Philippine President Duterte claims indifference to the Senate probe of Pharmaly and its government deals, but he still spoke about it at length in a pre-recorded briefing with the government's COVID-19 task force. Duterte says he no longer cares how long the Senate will continue to probe the issue. Several Pharmaly executives allegedly have links to the president. Duterte denies accusations of corruption in the Pharmaly deals. He instead threw the accusation back at Senators Richard Gordon and Frank Trillon.
Alam mo, sa totoo lang, Gordon pati Trillon, hindi ako abot sa presidency. From my mayorship to the presidency, kung corrupt ako kagaya ninyo. Kayo dyan ang merong butas, wala kayong makuha sa amin.
Drilon denies Duterte's allegations. He points out he has never been tried for corruption at any point in his decades of public service.
Pharmaly Pharmaceuticals slaps a lawsuit against Senator Risa Ontiveros, who exposed the company for its supposed misdeeds in its supply deals with the Philippine government. Ontiveros faces charges of sedition, perjury, and offering of a false witness before the Office of the Ombudsman. This after a former Pharmaly worker recanted his earlier statements against the firm. Vijay Almira now claims Ontiveros bribed him to say that Pharmaly had changed the expiration dates of some face shields.
Bago po nila ako tulungan pa, bigyan ng pinansyal na tulong para sa anak ko na may sakit. At yun po muna yung hiningin nilang mga kapalit bago po nila ako tulungan. Sabi nila gagawa daw po kami ng video, then after daw po nun, tsaka po nila ako babayaran para kasi nawalan po ako ng trabaho. Tapos ayun po, pagkatapos po ng video, tsaka po ulit nila ako binayaran ng 10,000 na cash. Tapos nung mga ilang linggo po lumipas, may nag-message po kasi sa akin na may numahanap na po sa akin na dalawang nakamotor. Totoo po yun. Tapos nung ang ginawa po nila kagad is ipaparelocate daw po nila ako. Then pumayag naman po ako na magparelocate.
Ontiveros retaliated by showing to the media screenshots of Almira's messages to her office, where he volunteered to provide information about alleged irregularities in Pharmaly's operations.
The charge to commit sedition is laughable. I don't need to resort to unlawful means to point out anomalies in Pharmaly's transactions. The Senate has already exposed many of these pieces of information. This is clearly a last-ditch effort by Pharmaly and its backers. Para pasinungalingan yung isang witness na nung una ay lakas loob na naggawa ng video at sworn affidavits pa. Tapos para baluktutin yung kwento, para umatake sa prosesong ginagawa namin at ginagawan pa ng kasinungalingan, sino ba naman ang hindi magagalit?
The senator's camp is now studying the possibility of filing countercharges against Pharmaly. And just to be clear, the actual charge is conspiracy to commit sedition. The Senate probe into the Pharmaly controversy resumes later this morning, but Health Secretary Francisco Duque III says no DOH official will attend due to President Duterte's memorandum order barring executive officials from the hearings. Another key figure that's been absent lately is former Budget Undersecretary Lloyd Christopher Lau. Senator Panfilo Lacson says he will cite Lau in contempt if he doesn't show up again later. Lacson points out Lau is not covered by Duterte's memo.
The Philippines' COVID-19 inoculation drive poised to shift into high gear as more adolescents become eligible to get the jab. Vivian Gulia reports.
Hundreds of minors without comorbidities and their parents or guardians lined up at a jabbing site in Parañaque City Wednesday as the country formally kicks off the COVID vaccination of the general pediatric population. Among them was Marisa, who waited 3 hours to have her two children inoculated.
Masaya kami bilang mga magulang kasi para po maging ligtas din po yung mga anak namin.
Parañaque City opened 4 mega sites for its general pediatric population. Mayor Edwin Olivares hopes to administer at least one COVID shot by end of November to all 12 to 17-year-olds in the city, which are at around 65,000.
Right now, hindi po tayo pumapayag na walk-in. Lahat po nakaregister. Binibigyan natin sila ng SM message, pati text messages, na meron silang specific hour, specific day. At doon po sa percentage po namin, doon sa ating OSPAR, nasa 90% ang dumadating to be vaccine.
In the city of Manila, residents belonging to the 12 to 17 age group also lined up early for COVID vaccination. In San Juan, 800 minors without comorbidities were scheduled to be jabbed Wednesday, while Navotas added 2 vaccination sites for the general pediatric population. The Marikina City government plans to inoculate 2,000 children daily in its mega vaccination site at the Marikina Sports Center.
We are hoping that with the opening up of our pediatric age group, mainganyo na rin yung ating mga lolo, mga lola na magpabakuna.
Of the 12.7 million children 12 to 17 years old in the Philippines, 37,964 received their first COVID shot. Vaccine Czar Secretary Carlito Galvez Jr. sees the COVID vaccination of 5 to 11-year-olds to begin in the country around the first quarter of 2022, after U.S. CDC advisors recommended it for that age group. Local experts, meanwhile, are studying data submitted by 4 COVID vaccine manufacturers regarding their application for booster shot and third dose. These are Pfizer, AstraZeneca, Sinovac, and Gamaleya.
We will advise Moderna also to apply for the boosters. We will talk to Mama Gloriani, yung ating vaccine expert panel, na kung pwede ma-expedite so that we could proceed immediately after 2 weeks.
Galvez expects the country to begin administering booster and third dose shots on November 15. Of the close to 109 million COVID jabs that arrived in the Philippines, around 48 million have yet to be used. This is why the government plans to hold a national COVID vaccination day this November. The target is to vaccinate 5 million individuals on that day.
Lahat po ng mga doktor, yung mga lahat po ng mga nurses, yung lahat po ng mga volunteers, yung lahat ng mga NGOs, lahat ng mga government agencies, yung DepEd, idadrop po natin ang gagawin natin, ang gagawin po natin sa araw na yon, vaccination lang. Parang yung national election. So, hahakutin natin yung lahat ng mga hindi na babaccinate.
Galvez also recommended to the president to incentivize the vaccinated and disincentivize those without a COVID jab.
Ang nakita natin, hindi na sila makakalabas. For example, they cannot go to the malls. They cannot go to the dine-ins. They cannot go to cinema. Like what the Israelis are doing. Yung mga iba, hindi makapagano sa concert, hindi ka makapag-attend ng mass. And then they have a regular swabbing every week at their expense.
So far, 27.7 million Filipinos, or nearly 36% of the target 70% of the Philippine population, have been fully vaccinated against COVID. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.